Then now we will see for vitamin B2. This is also known as riboflavin. And like vitamin B1, this is also thermostable. विटामिन बी वन भी हमारा थर्मोस्टेबल था, ये भी थर्मोस्टेबल है, हीट को विथस्टैंड करता है, हीट में ये प्रॉब्लम नहीं होती है इसको, और ये स्टेबल रहता है हीट में. सो थोड़ा सा टेम्परेचर बढ़ेगा तो भी इसको कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं आती है, बट दिस इज सेंसिटिव टू लाइट. सो इट इज सेंसिटिव टू लाइट एंड इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इंटू ल्यूमिनफ्लेविन. After exposure to light, it gets converted to lumiflavin, which is exhibiting a yellow fluorescent. It gives a yellow fluorescent color, so that will be characteristic of the vitamin B12. अगर ये light में exposed हुआ तो. Now this generally undergoes redox reactions. And participates in acceptance of electron or acceptance or donation of electrons. It either donates the electrons or it accepts the electrons. So the coenzyme forms of this will be flavin mononucleotide and flavin adenosine dinucleotide. So there are two coenzyme forms for vitamin B2. The structure for this will be it consists of isoalloxazine ring with two methyl groups, one at sixth position and the other at seventh position. This is isoalloxazine ring with two methyl groups, so it is a 6-7 dimethyl isoalloxazine, and here at this position we have a ribitol attached to it. It is a ribose that is attached to this nitrogen. We have this as a D-ribitol and this part is a 6-7 dimethyl isoalloxazine. D-ribitol attached to the third nitrogen, its numbering starts from here as 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and this one is 4. The coenzyme forms for this There are two coenzyme forms for this. Panase, flavin, mononucleotide. We call it as FMN. Here it will be almost similar. 3CHOH, we have CH2O attached with a phosphate group. This will be our flavin mononucleotide. The second is flavin adenosine dinucleotide. We call it as FAD. Structure for this also remains very much similar. But the side chain, ribitol side chain, will be different. We have CHOH spice, CH2. Instead of one phosphate, now there will be two phosphate groups. These phosphate groups are then attached to ribose via 5' prime position of the ribose. Which is having at first position there is a adenosine group. So this is our flavin adenosine dinucleotide. So these are the two coenzyme forms for vitamin B12. Next is sources of vitamin B2. Vitamin B2 is present in a wide variety in the nature, so there are lots of sources are there for vitamin B2, and the deficiency of this rarely occurs because of its wide distribution in nature. It can be available both as a free pigment as well as a constituent of flavoproteins, where this vitamin B2 is a part of the protein, so it becomes a riboflavin attached to a protein, so we call it as a flavoprotein. Diets include the green and leafy vegetables as a good sources of vitamin B12. Similarly, yellow vegetables are also good sources of vitamin B12. Then we have cereals as good sources of vitamin B12. We have fish, meat, eggs and poultry products as good sources of vitamin B12. Similarly, it is also present in milk and milk products. Milk and milk products are also good sources of vitamin B12. So, in almost all food that we consume, vitamin B12 is present. Hence, its deficiency rarely occurs. But whenever the deficiency occurs, there is association of other vitamin deficiencies are also being observed along with the deficiency of vitamin B2. So as such, just vitamin B2 ka deficiency नहीं आता है, लेकिन उसके साथ में अगर दूसरे विटामिन का डेफिशिएंसी होगा तो उनके साथ में डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ विटामिन B2 भी एसोसिएट हो सकता है. सिर्फ विटामिन B2 का डेफिशिएंसी रेयरली होता है, बट इट कैन बी एसोसिएटेड विद डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ अदर विटामिन्स. मेजर डेफिशिएंसी डिसीजेस फॉर विटामिन B2 आर चिलोसिस, विच इज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय fissures around mouth, जो मुंह फटना वगैरह हम बोलते हैं, so that is chilosis and it is the deficiency of the vitamin B2. At the corners of the mouth, the skin will get fissured. या फिर उसमें मुंह फटना जो हम बोलते हैं, इसमें कि skin फट जाती है, so that is our chilosis will be there. Then second is glossitis. Glossitis is characterized by smooth and purplish tongue. Tongue becomes very smooth and purple in color. So that is one thing. Then there is a dermatitis. That is a skin problem. Skin diseases will happen because of the deficiency of vitamin B12. Similarly, riboflavin can be associated with other vitamin deficiencies, and the long-term alcoholics जो regular alcohol consume करते हैं, they are susceptible to deficiency of vitamin B2. Susceptible to deficiency of vitamin B2. The deficiency of vitamin B2 retards the overall growth of organism. Overall growth of organism is retarded, and there is a general weakness if there is a deficiency of vitamin B2. So these are deficiency diseases of vitamin deficiency diseases associated with the vitamin B2 deficiency. Then we have biochemical functions. Vitamin B2 is associated with redox reactions as an acceptor or donor of electrons. So it can accept a pair of electrons or it can donate a pair of electrons. So it donates or accepts two electrons at a time and two protons at a time. So both this FMN as well as FAD, both will be accepting electrons and donating the electrons. So we can have a general reaction associated with either the FMN or FA2. FAD is, if this is suppose say R, for FMN it will be a ribitol and a phosphate. For FAD, it will be a ribitol, diphosphate or pyrophosphate, ribose and adenosine. So this will be the general structure for either an FMN as well as FAD. It accepts two electrons and two protons to get reduced. So here what we can see is we have got one proton added over here, the other proton is added over this nitrogen, and the double bonds that were present here, one of the double bond has got reduced and the other has shifted over here. So we got the two double bonds, that is two electrons have been accommodated in this. So this is now becoming a reduced form of riboflavin. Let me call it as either a FMNH2 or FADH2. So this becomes a FMNH2 or FADH2. The synthesis of vitamin B2 can be started with the aniline derivative 3,4-dimethyl aniline. It is a very short synthesis. This can react with ribose D ribose reacts with 3,4-dimethyl aniline. When heat with heat, there will be a condensation. With the loss of water molecule, CH2OH price, CH2OH. This molecule then further be reduced by platinum, palladium, CH2, CHOH, thrice, CH2OH. Now this molecule can be reacted with paranitro, benzene, diazonium chloride. Paranitro, benzene, diazonium chloride. CH3 here. We have a nitrogen. Double bond nitrogen. associated with a benzene ring, para position nitro group, here NH, CH2, CHOH thrice, CH2OH. We can reduce this in presence of nickel so that this nitrogen double bond can be reduced and also this particular group can be removed out, so that it will remove as a paranitro aniline and this will become an amine group. अमीन ग्रुप रहेगा और बाकी का पार्ट वहां से निकल जाता है. दिस रिमेन्स CHOH थ्राइस CH2OH as such. नाउ इफ वी रिएक्ट इट विद आइसो वी रिएक्ट इट विद एलोक्सेन एलोक्सेन रिंग. This is alloxane. Here H and OH reacts and this side H2 and this O reacts, so that there will be a loss of two water molecules and we will have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 membered ring. Carbonyl, nitrogen, H, here we have CH2, CHOH, thrice, and CH2OH. That is riboflavin or vitamin B. So a simple synthesis of vitamin B2 can be done right from 3-4 dimethyl aniline. We can start with 3-4 dimethyl aniline and in a few steps only we can reach the vitamin B2.